Very good morning, my dear students. Today you are going to learn about ultrasonic techniques applied on tissue reactions. So it is highly helpful for capturing the images. So this tissue reaction only provides the imaging about the internal organs. Here the ultrasonic tissue reaction you are going to learn it. Here usually ultrasound waves, it's several different reflector surface. Interaction with the tissue causes the ultrasound energy to diminish and become weaker as it penetrates deeper. So this is also known as attenuation and is similar to the sound that becomes fainter when moves further away from it. So when crystal, this is the pulse echo principle, when the crystal is electrically pulsed, it changes the shape and vibrates, produce sound beam that propagates through the tissue and reflected echoes reach the transducer, and it vibrates and produces the electric voltage comparable to the returning echoes. So here they are sending the ultrasound that is penetrating, this is the surface of the body, and ultrasound is penetrating inside the internal organs. After striking the internal organs, these ultrasound waves are reflected. So these reflected sound we are calling as a pulse echoes that has been captured by the same transducer by a reflection method. So here the ultrasound is converted into the electrical signal. Now here the advantage of high frequency is they are using above 10 MHz. So that is have been generated by the transducer with their improved spatial resolution along with the development such as a multi-frequency transducer. So compound imaging and beam steering as a meet further the application for musculoskeletal ultrasound continue to introduce here. It is having a tender and a ligament nerve and muscles are now ready to shown by the ultrasound here. So ultrasound tissue reaction, it is based on reflection, refraction, absorption, attenuation and scattering. So what is reflection here? So here the reflection of a beam is called the echoes. So the protection and the detection of echoes from the basis of ultrasound, the reflection occurs at the interface between the two material. It is depend upon the property of a material, that name is called acoustic impedance. If the two materials have the same impedance, no echoes are produced. This is the reflection properties. So the difference between the acoustic impedance, that is a small weak echo is produced, and most of the sound waves will continue in a second medium. So large and strong is produced, that is a very large, that is all sound waves will be totally reflected back. So when totally reflected back, we are getting large strength strong echoes. So if acoustics having impedance, we are getting small weak echoes. Example for large strong echo is the tissue air interface, that is 99% of beam is reflected back. So specular reflection, what we are going to learn, which occurs at a large changes in impedance, produces a large reflection and also reduces the continuing wave amplitude. Here the medium reflections, which is occurs in the dense tissues such as the muscles. So another reflection is called the diffuse reflection, which is occurs with the softer tissue such as the liver. So here specular reflectors, we can tell it about the diaphragm and wall of the urine filled urinary bladder, endometrial stripe. So these are all comes under specular reflectors. It's which giving images with the help of that one. So different types of reflections are there. So here the specular reflection, this one, and non-specular reflection means that is there will be a scattering. specular reflection produce a larger strength echoes that you are seeing here. So here it is called that is reacted by the sound wave. So here specular means it is reflected at 45 degree, it will be reflected. So this is the incident wave striking at surface and penetrating inside, after that reflected. So this is a diffused reflection. Diffuse means, so one incident wave strikes at some angle, it will be scattered in a other direction. This is called a diffuse reflection. So the refraction, we are going to next learn about the tissue reaction. In a tissue reaction, refraction also it is there. So it is when is ultrasound striking at with the one angle, it will be easily penetrating through the other medium. Okay, it is moving from one medium to another medium. So this is the air medium that is considered, that is a transducer medium, and this is a tissue medium, consider tissue medium, and it is moving, or else we have in our body there is a different tissues. These tissues, first tissue is called A, second tissue is called B. Okay, you can see here. So here when you are propagating the ultrasound wave, encounter is a specular interface at the opaque angle. So opaque angle, okay, oblique angle, it is reflected in the same way, that is the light is refracted through the lens. So the portion of the wave is first not reflected continuous into the second medium with the changes in the direction. It is depend on the velocity of the two medium. If the velocity are equal, there would be no refraction occurs and the beam goes straight into the second medium. So for what is velocities at different medium tissue in the human body having and are quite close, and refraction can be ignored. So absorption, third one is absorption. So that is a tissue reaction. So causes, it is a removal of energy from the ultrasound beam and evident dispersion of this energy primarily as a heat. So sound is propagated by the displacement of molecule of a medium into the region of compression and rarefaction phenomena. So therefore the energy of ultrasound beam is generally reduced as the it is passes through the medium. So scattering, fourth one is scattering in a tissue reaction. So not all the echoes are reflected back to the probe, some of them are scattered in all direction in a non uniform manner. So more so with the very small object or rough surfaces are used. So part of the scattering goes back to the transducer and generate the image is called backscatter. So what is backscatter? So backscatter or Rayleigh scattering, which occurs structure smaller than the transmitted wavelength, and the reflected energy is very low here. So but contributes to textures of the image. So it you are seeing in the diagram. Next one is attenuation. So loss, what is attenuation? Losses of intensity of sound during the propagation due to mainly reflection, refraction and absorption. The attenuation of ultrasound waves occurs when it propagating through the medium. So you are seeing here. So compression and rarefaction manner it will travel. So loss of propagating energy will be in the form of heat absorbed by the tissues, approximately 1 dB per centimeter per 1 MHz, or caused by the wave front dispersion or a wave scattering. So now we'll see that ultrasound tissue interaction. So this is attenuation have been taken place in this diagram, absorption taken place in this diagram, reflection have been takes in the place diagram, scattering is taken place in the diagram, and refraction have been taken place in the diagram, diffraction have been taken place in the diagram. So this is the different tissue reaction. Thank you for listening, class.